With drama, just a lot. I was just in a live stream that was real crazy.
Yeah, but you feel like you're ugly. That's why you sent it to me. Like, you didn't have to send me that. Like, why are you trying to prove to me? Like, my opinion shouldn't matter. You don't like me anyway, right? No, I was trying to flex. And it was a... Let me tell you something. That's not a photo to use to flex, because it wasn't even a good one. But okay. I mean, what are you flexing on? You called me fat. I just told you the truth and you didn't like it. You act ugly on the inside, you're ugly on the outside. You didn't have to message me and call me fat. Like, why do people feel so compelled to say things? That's why I don't look at my requested DMs, because people are rude in there. I've just blocked a lot of comments of people calling me a pig, calling me fat. Like, okay, can you say something else? Other than that, like, you have that written down on a card where you just use it every time. You're fat, you're old, you're this, you're that. Like, okay. How many times have I heard that? Like, got anything different? Like, and it's constantly, like, people are being just rude in DMs. It's just like, at this point, I really truly don't care. Anyways, what I was going to say, I was going to say something else too. Oh, someone had the nerve to write in messages and literally DM. They DM'd me and said that I should have gave that money. I should have donated it. Because I didn't do a giveaway because we didn't hit the goal. Now you're telling me I should have donated. Yeah, I said 150K. That I should have donated the money that was given to me for my birthday. How selfish do you have to be to tell me to donate when you ain't donated ish of your money to Gaza? How about that? Because I don't see you donating anything to anyone, much less let alone saying ish. So why are you getting mad at me for what I chose to do with my birthday money, which is none of your business? And you literally want to have the nerve to DM me and tell me I should have donated because you're mad I got birthday money? No, you should donate your rent money so you don't have any. Hey, like, give your rent money, okay? And become homeless for people of Gaza, because clearly that would prove that you're doing something for them. I mean... You know, I'm just joking with them, but still, like, for them to literally message and be like, donate, for them to literally say, like, you should have donated your, to see if you get a refund, no, I didn't want to wear the wig today, to see if you get the refund or, get it sent out, and I was like, okay, whatever. I was like, okay, have a good day. You know, I was very positive, but I'm like so angry. Like, I keep calling and they keep like putting it off and putting it off. How hard is it to give someone their items that they are owed? Like, this is the third time something from my wish list, thank you for the heart me, has not been sent and it has the correct address. Like, I'm so frustrated. Like, I'm so frustrated, I'm so annoyed. It's just like, It's just like, I am so annoyed. Like, why do I gotta keep waiting for my stuff? So then the person that has sent the stuff called, and they told them they have to wait 3 days to either get a refund, or they're not gonna refund it because they said they're having an error message. I don't know. It's on their end. They won't refund the money, and they won't send the items. And I'm waiting. Like, I've been patiently waiting, and I'm annoyed. So if they refund it, the person's just gonna give me the money, and I can get whatever I want with it. So, yeah, I'm just gonna reorder the same stuff I was getting. I was like, should I get the makeup brushes? But I will. Because it's bronzer, makeup brushes, and I might order some other stuff, like pressed powders. So yeah, I'm excited for this new makeup palette to come, because I'm going to start doing, like, makeup looks. This one has a lot of colors in it, so. Yeah, setting powder. Maybe, I don't know, we'll see. I keep forgetting I have to get a microphone for this podcast thing. So yeah, hold on guys. It's gonna load. Okay. Hello. We got a sub. Thank you for subscribing. Welcome. But yeah, I'm gonna be doing more looks. Well, the cream bronzer, that's really gonna work on my face. So yeah. Cause I've been watching other people's stuff has been coming on my For You page, like the iShow Speed stuff. And other people. There was someone talking to minors or something, I don't know. It was on my For You page. Somebody was trying to justify saying, if you show me that he said this or did this, I'll switch sides. And they were like, why do you need to see that to switch sides? Like, it was somebody. And the photo kind of looked like Austin McBroom, and I know it's not Austin McBroom, which is wild because Austin McBroom is having a dating show. And in the thing, because you know his brother, right? Landon. Anyways, we got another sub. Thank you. So anyways, Austin McBroom. Hey. Like, why? Why would you do that? You literally subscribed and then said that. Immediately blocked. Like, what was the reasoning behind that? There's no pickles. He had the pickles under his tongue. Sorry. You know, since they wanted to say bubble bass, I tried to do an impression of bubble bass. There's no pickles.
The following is a paid presentation from LifeLock.
Not LifeLock.
I thought I'd be the last person on earth this would happen to. I change my passwords all the time. I shred my documents, and I lock.
Hold on, let me change it.
I thought I was bulletproof, honestly. Someone stole my social security number and filed a tax return in my name.
I literally have a hangnail, guys. It hurts, and I'm trying to get it off.
But not you yet. You check
your bank accounts and credit. Set up complex passwords. Shred important documents. No one's getting past your protections. But the reality is, identity thieves don't have to, because your information is already in the hands of others and out of your control.
I did everything right, but an institution that had my data didn't, and my identity was stolen.
From hospitals, to your employer, government agencies, to retailers, and so many other places you interact with. The information thieves need to steal your identity is in countless hands that aren't always...
Where's the remote?
As you are.
So I can change information, it. Sensitive financial information is out there in so many places that we absolutely have no control over. We were responsible for $75,000 in an auto loan that we didn't even take out.
Let me make this very, very clear. You could do nothing wrong. Be 100% perfect about all of your security.
Try not to.
Still be a victim of
take this off.
$110,000 of my part gone.
I'm Tom Morski, and over the next half hour, we'll show
that is a good drink. It is the best drink. Calypso is really good.
With LifeLock.
Well, let me get the remote.
Mercedes and Jim have always taken their privacy seriously. So much so that when they sold their house, they went out of their way to shred over 150 pounds of their old paperwork.
I felt so secure that I'd done everything.
Boogie Nights, Chai is coming on. Ever been watching Chai? Ow. That's a show that they've been showing on TV, and I've been getting into it. Hunger Games is on, Reba's on, South Park. I don't like Medea. Goosebumps is on. The mega brands that built America. Oh. Ow. Like, look. Our feedback from my mom's headphones is annoying. But she's listening to my live. Ouch. Titanic is on, but they've been showing Titanic a lot. Sleeping with the Enemy. Ace Ventura's on. I'll just put it on the Lifetime. Sleeping with the Enemy. We are not gonna watch Seinfeld. Nope, I don't support PD3Os. I don't have eyeliner. Or else I would have worn it. No, my eyebrows are there, see? They're right here. I just probably covered them up with foundation. I was just in a hurry to get my makeup over so I could go live. But I did, because I have the eyebrow thing they gave me. I do use it to try to fill them in, but It's just kind of a little light. Oh, that's that movie we watched with Julia Roberts. And she has a crazy stalker boyfriend. That's the one where she pretends that she drowned in the ocean so she could get away from her boyfriend. The bronzer hasn't come in yet. They said it's gonna take 3 days and then we'll see if we get a refund or if they deliver the items. That guy really does look evil. He looks like he's in a scary movie or something. He probably was. I feel like he was in a scary movie or something like that. Someone got stuff from my wish list, which was a makeup palette, bronzer, and the makeup brushes I had on my wish list. It said delivered, but it didn't get delivered. So I called them. They told me to wait for the grace period. I called back. They told me that there was some system error on their end, and I have to wait 5 business days to see if I either got a refund or they're going to resend the stuff. Then the person that had the stuff sent called them, and they literally said it's going to take three business days to see if we get a refund or if we get the stuff sent, if they're going to send the stuff back out or give a refund. And I'm like, that's crazy. Just give us a refund. Because she said they're hoping that you just don't, like, do anything with it. And that they won't have to give you a refund. So that's why she made sure to call them and see what was going on. And I said, yeah, you're absolutely right. They think it's Temu because they literally said I didn't buy once from Temu. Yes, I did. Everything I bought at the same time from Temu, it came in different packages, but I bought. The only thing I got was 2 free items, which was the, you know, the lace melting. Yeah, it's the lace melting bands. It's the lace melting bands and the glasses, I think, that I got free. So, everything came all separate. No, Justin's not here. Finger hurts.
I dropped it right next to your foot, my iPod.
No, it's not.
Do you see it? It's right by your chair. I'll get it.
It's way over there, Mom. I can't. But yeah. So, because of that, they said I have to wait 3 business. It's just issue a refund. I didn't receive my items. Why do I gotta wait 3 business days? I'm so annoyed. Like, I already waited 1 day and then I have to wait 3 business days for you to give me my items. Like, it's not that hard. No. Like, I don't know, Jeff Bezos. You better give me my stuff. Because I'm going to sue you for some money. I'm just kidding. Jeff better. For some money. I'm just kidding. Jeff better. Happened though. And it's the right address. Someone tried to order the press on nails. That didn't get sent. They tried to resend it, but they ended up getting a refund back. I don't know. They said they went to resend it, and they were given a refund. So
they opted out, and that's the one that sent me the shoes, the Vans. Then they said they would send more, and they're going to send nails at a later time. And thank you for the heart me. And then someone sent the wig and the whole the wig, and it was a whole pack of like Shea Moisture stuff. It was shampoo, Shea Moisture shampoo, Shea Moisture conditioner, and the curl enhancing smoothie that I use. That came in a 3-pack, and that one didn't deliver with the wig. And it said delivered, but it didn't deliver. So then I had to call, I had to call them, and they had to re-deliver it. And then the makeup stuff, like, and then I'm trying to do that. And like I told her, I said, I need to figure out if this is going to send, because I can't keep having this issue. And I said, thank you for the gift points. I said, I can't keep having this issue of it saying delivered and it's not sending, because I want to fix the address, because I knew the makeup stuff was coming. Excuse me. She said it was resolved, and then we have this issue with the makeup. But no, if I haven't received it on the date I was supposed to receive it, which is June 6th, they're supposed to issue an immediate refund. That's what I'm saying. Like, literally. That's what there is no waiting. It was supposed to be here on the 6th. We're already like, what, the 10th? So why should I have to wait that long? I do have Amazon Prime, actually. I do have Amazon Prime. It's paid for. Oh, I forgot. I think I have to cancel my subscription. I'm going to call them and cancel my subscription and be like, I haven't received any of my stuff. But anyways, I'm so annoyed at the fact that, you know. Yeah, it goes to the office, though. They don't deliver packages to the door. It goes straight to the office. But the thing that I'm annoyed about is why I'm not, and the person said that they do that because they refuse to give people the items. That's what it is. They're refusing to they're hoping maybe it'll blow off, if that makes sense, so they don't have to give a refund. That's what that person said. If we don't keep calling, they're going to hope maybe we forget about it so they can blow it off and they don't have to give a refund. Yeah, a lot of people get packages there to the office. The office doesn't care because it doesn't come to the door, because the doors, they don't have where you can put a package. If it's left at the door, someone will steal it. And I think that's why they have it go to the office. Because all the doors, people could have their package stolen. I tracked it, and it said delivered on June 6th, which is why I went to the office, and it was not delivered. And I knew, again, it wasn't going to be, because she was like, it said delivered. So I was like, you know what, I'm going to call them. And she said that they're hoping that, what they do is they hope that it blows off. That's what they say. Like, they're hoping it blows off so they don't have to give a refund. Probably, but I don't think so. Because why would they steal it? It's a package that was given to the front office. They have cameras. They can't take people's packages. I received my whole Temu order, so whenever people send packages themselves, I receive them. But there's literally, like, a camera. But, yeah. Maybe, but the thing is, like, there's cameras in the office, so they would get in trouble. They work on clock. Yeah, Amazon said that they would refund it, but they told me to wait for the grace period, which was 12 a.m. So I waited after 12 a.m. I called them, then they told me 5 business days because they had an error message.
I received a lot of packages, but from my wish list, this, like, three packages from my wish list, it, for some reason, it didn't work. Like, it said delivered, and it didn't deliver. But, they literally said, wait 5 business days. And I was like, that was my mom. They were like, you have to wait 5 business days because we have an error message. Like, it's messing up on our end. So, it's not letting me refund or do anything. So, I have to wait to see if I can issue a refund or send the item out. I'm like, your system's messed up. So, I gotta wait another 5 days because your system's messed up. That's crazy. So then the other person called them because they were like, she was like, they're going to wait. They're hoping that they wait long enough for you to forget so they can just like not give you a refund. And so she called and they told her she had to wait 3 business days. They gave her 3 business days and they said she had to wait because I don't know. I think it was the system error again that it's. To either get a refund or for them to resend it. I know they're not going to resend it. They're just going to give a refund. But it's so annoying because they could have just done that from the get-go. It's not that hard. They know how much it is. Like, why is their system messed up? They could just give a refund. Like, it was supposed to be here on the 6th. It wasn't. And I shouldn't have to wait. Like, almost a whole... It's getting... Like 2 weeks. That's outrageous. There's no one behind me. Like, I get it, just be patient, but they're not gonna resend it. I know they're just gonna give a refund. And it's just a wait. It's just a waste because I'm gonna have to order the items again and wait for them to come. And then that's so annoying and frustrating. I'll pick that up later. But yeah, there was a whole bunch of going on live streams. Like, a whole bunch of stuff. I got a random live and they were going in on this guy who was defending another guy. And then I was just like, dang.
You don't like that?
No, I do.
But... That is crazy. Anyways, but collect swag, but I'm not gonna collect it because you have to battle people. I don't battle. 100 heart me gifts sent in your live to get a rose card. I have 43. I need 100 out of 43 heart me's. To get a rose card. Sorry. That's that movie with Julia Roberts. Anyways. Oh, and guess what else? I'm facing a flag violation because someone got flagged for their comment towards me in a DM and they wanted to get butt hurt and report me. Like, I'm probably going to get banned from people sending me TikTok messages again. Again, like, I'm so annoyed, TikTok. Like, this is so annoying. Like, I'm getting annoyed at this point. Like, I'm getting so annoyed. We don't have another phone to battle.
Fall asleep, Bob.
Like, I'm so annoyed. They literally reported my comment because their comment got flagged because they called me an something ASS, and TikTok says it violated their guidelines. They got flagged, and I guess they got mad because their comment got reported and I didn't, so they reported my comment because I got a warning. I was like, again? I just got my messaging back, TikTok. I didn't do anything. I didn't even say anything that bad. Like, hello? Like, I'm so annoyed. Oop. Like, I'm so annoyed. What is this a thing? I barely get my DMs back on TikTok, and then you just take them away again. Like, there's no point in giving me direct messages on TikTok if you're gonna just take them away. Like, how am I violating guidelines? I didn't even say anything to the person. Yeah, I didn't even say anything bad to the person. I just said, what was it? They were, like, hating on me. And I said, I'm not gonna say anything rude. If I was going to say something rude, I just went and, like, deleted the comment before I sent it and sent something else. Because I'm like, I'm not trying to get banned in DMs. And, like, that's crazy. Nothing I said got me flagged. And I'm pretty sure I'm going to get it back. But then again, I don't think so. I don't know. TikTok has been on one. TikTok has been on one. Not a Lifetime original movie. It's always based on a true story. They were showing that one of that girl that was held captive as a minor. This guy held her captive. Sorry, my eyes are watering. They were showing some good movies today. Disney movies, you know how they've been showing Disney movies all summer? They showed, no, it's just that I yawned and now my eyes are watery. They showed Coco, because I was like, I watched the whole movie. Every time I see that movie, it's sad. And then, they were showing Cars. They showed Inside Out, Tangled. You guys must not really want the chat. They must not really want to speak. I kind of want to get off and go to bed. I try to as long as I can on this live. Ouch. No, they can spam 250, they just don't want to. How do you get makeup out of this look? Oh, and look. Like, I got makeup on it, and I love this bandana. Oh, hold on, let me... Don't go down there, please. I need to put soap directly on it, wash it. I'm gonna have to put soap directly on it and just scrub it. That might work. I think if I use a toothbrush and scrub it in there, it might, that's what I do with the makeup brushes or the, you know, I use this soap, because they said you could use that, and with the beauty blenders, it works. It gets the makeup all out of my beauty blender. It looks brand new. It looks brand new every single time. And the makeup brushes, I just put like, I just put soap, and then I scrub the brush in the soap, and then I rinse it off. And it takes the eyeshadow out, and it gets out all the makeup. And then I washed these with soap. But I think it might have ruined them. Because they have makeup stuck at the ends. And I try to take the extra makeup off. So yeah. Yeah, there's another one of those white triangle, rectangle type sponges that I was given, and I use that sometimes, and it literally got some of the makeup out. It's just a little slightly stained because, you know, it's white. And it literally looks brand new. Like, it's easy if you use just this soap. Some people use vinegar and baking powder, but if you just use soap and it's just soap, no water, no nothing. You put a bunch of soap in a cup, you take your beauty blender, and you scrub it in the soap, and then what you do is you run water, and then you squeeze it out, like if you're gonna, then I take a toilet paper and I squeeze it out too. So I can get all the excess water out, like if you were going to use it on your face, then I let it dry. So yeah. That's how I let it dry. That's not even her. Oh. That's what I do to get the makeup out, because, oh, it was funny. So I did that, right? And there was still makeup on the sponge. So it was like, oh, it's not going to get 100% clean. Let me tell you, I did again when I recently used the beauty blender, and it came out. It was not stained, and all the stain came out, like it was gone. It was like completely gone. It looked like a brand new beauty blender. Because, like, I don't have any other, like, ways to clean my stuff. So I just use that. But yeah, because I don't have anything else to clean my makeup brushes and stuff like that with. I need to get one of those makeup brush things where you just, like, go over the thing. But yeah. This looks bad. These eyelashes, because I washed them with soap and I think they clumped together. Because I washed them with soap because it had the makeup still stuck on the band. So I was like, I was going to look up how to wash them. And I was like, you know what? I'll just go like that. Yeah, I don't have eyeliner. And I keep saying, like, oh, I'm going to buy extra. Then I forget I have to get a microphone. But, you know, we all good, I guess. It looks like it hurts taking the ring off because her finger's kind of bent. There's this account, I don't know if I told you guys, I don't know if there's anyone here that's a huge fan of Shelley Duvall. You know, I'm a fan of Shelley Duvall. And the other day The Shining was on, right? And so Shelley Duvall from The Shining, and she was also Olive Oil in the Popeye movies. She was in, I forget what other movies she's been in, but anyways. So there's this account I cosplayed as Wendy Torrance from The Shining. And this account popped up, and it was a Shelley Duvall fan account. And I was like, oh, cool, let me follow. Because how funny the Shelley Duvall fan account pops up when I dressed up as Wendy Torrance from The Shining. Shelley Duvall, it was really close friends with Robin Williams. She was Olive Oil in Popeye, and he was Popeye in the movie Popeye. We all know Robin Williams. She was friends with him. She briefly dated Ringo Starr from the Beatles. She was in the movie The Shining with Jack Nicholson. And Stanley Kubrick, who I believe is either the writer or the director of The Shining, played a huge role in her acting career because at that time she wasn't really an actor trying to get gigs and stuff. But she ended up landing the role for Stanley Kubrick's Shining. You know, Stephen King. Original book is Stephen King. But anyways. So, she went viral. Well, not viral, because it was like back in the day. She was in a magazine and she was known for the cartoonish, over-the-top lashes she had. Her, if I could pull it up and show you, I would like her lashes or whatever. Anyways, she was like modeling for magazines too. Like she was good. Around Texas, and who does she see? Shelley Duvall. She ends up becoming friends with Shelley Duvall, who she loves to spread awareness about Shelley because there's a lot of misinformation. There was being misinformation spread about The Shining that she hated working on The Shining. She hated Stanley Kubrick. She hated Jack Nicholson, which was not true. And I believed that for years, that it really messed up her mental when she had to do that bat scene 100 times. Like, I heard all of this misinformation. And I was it literally changed my perception on things, because it was like, oh, now this was a whole lie. Like, this misinformation being spread was bad. So anyways, she gained a lot of fans where people were like, oh, they wanted to send stuff to Shelley. She made a P.O. box to send letters to Shelley, and she says that she could send some of the letters to Shelley, but she might not be able to send all of them. And I was like, I should write a letter to Shelley Duvall. And I was like, you know what? If you guys want to, I was like, because if there are Shelley fans in the live, like, I could literally be like, go to the page and like, and like, look up the P.O. box and like, send Shelley a letter, because I think that would be cool. And so, howdy, howdy, howdy. Yeah, there was some things on Facebook. Shelley Duvall is a legend. Look her up. She literally is a legend. She was in The Shining. It is. She was in the movie The Shining. If you like horror flicks, like Stephen King movies, you'll love that one. Because it's based off of an actual real haunted hotel that Stephen King stayed at. And literally, that's how The Shining came to be. And I think it was either that or he had a dream. But anyways, yeah, so it is like a horror flick. I don't know if you've ever seen the infamous line, "Here's Johnny." And he's like, he just like takes the axe and like knocks the door open. That's literally, hold on guys. That's literally. Letters, and she's like, I may not get the letters to get all the letters to her, but I can try to. And I was like, that'd be cool, just to write a letter and see if she gets it. Shelley Duvall, she is literally a living legend. She was in a lot of movies. She famously dated for not that long, Ringo Starr from the Beatles. We all know the Beatles. She was friends with Robin Williams. She played Olive Oil in Popeye. And obviously, Robin Williams played Popeye, but she was Olive Oil. If you've seen the live movie, like, it's, I don't want to say live action because it was not called live action back then, but it was a movie called Popeye with Shelley Duvall and Robin Williams. She had her infamous interview with why was I going to say Dr. Trump? Not Dr. Trump. She had an interview with Dr. Phil, which I didn't even like. It was a horrible interview in which she was having a manic episode because I guess she was having a mental health crisis at the time. And she went live on air and said that Robin Williams is somewhere shape-shifting, that she doesn't believe that he's gone, that she believes he's shape-shifting somewhere, or that somewhat what she was explaining was, I guess she thinks he's alive. Which was crazy. He tried to get her help. When she left the show to get rehabilitation, she didn't stay rehabilitated. She left the rehabilitation center, and that video was used to exploit her for money. Or the interview was used to exploit her for money. Because Dr. Phil should have not let her up there to say that. Especially because Robin Williams still has family. Like, imagine his family having to hear her say that she believes he's alive and shape-shifting somewhere. She's just shape-shifting. Or, I mean, she was like, he's just shape-shifting somewhere. Okay. Like, that's crazy. But, you know. So, yeah. But thank you. Blocked. Maybe pay to come and say that? Oh, you won't. To be haters, they made a username and they got blocked. Yeah, well, they just get blocked. Dang, people sending TikTok universes, like, send one to me. People are rich. TikTok universes are not cheap by the slightest. Hella expensive. And it'd be the most problematic ones that'd be on the leaderboard, too. Like, Pretty Boy Ali, he was known to gift himself through an agency. This agency was consistently dropping $500,000 every single time for him to keep him number one, and he got caught because they exposed him for an agency dropping $500 diamonds for him to automatically get number one every time. Because if you're, like, the leaderboards are for a reason. If you're number one on the leaderboard, you get extra diamonds for that. Like, extra, what they call diamonds. And so that's why people try to fight for the number one spot on the leaderboard. Because you get a banner that says, like, number one. And you also get a lot of stuff for being number one on the leaderboard. So, anyways, him, Jeffree Star, too. Jeffree Star is another one that's always on the leaderboard. I'm like, why? Not really. A lot of the people that are on the leaderboards recycle. Recycling means using money that they get from gift points and giving and gifting themselves. Some of them have accounts where they gift themselves to help themselves stay on the leaderboards. Like, hard work is hard work at all. Jeffree Star is a recycler. I wouldn't put it past him. But he does drop for people on live streams. Like, he used to drop a lot. I don't know if he's been going live recently or he got banned, because I haven't seen him. And I haven't heard anything of Eugenia, because she used to go live too. It's doing that again. But, yeah, you know, I know. I mean, I'm not going to be rude, but she has a problem that she needs, you know. Who's my favorite live streamer? I don't really have one. Except the one that I watched that we're in a group chat. Except, sadly, her life's been filled with drama that has not been a good drama. That's the one where someone on the live, it was admitted that people, trolls, and a group chat went out of their way to recently get this girl fired from her job. Literally, she just got the job and she gave hints, and the trolls went and, like, left negative reviews under her job and got her fired. And this person's significant other's past got brought up. And because his past got brought up of him being a past racist. And he has since educated himself and done and put a lot of work into, you know, educating himself. Which I don't understand why people bring up stuff from the past. They expose something from 10 years ago. They shared it with a scammer who is literally on the app begging for money, but has a bunch of dogs they're not taking care of. And it was a whole thing. And it was really sad because she was upset on her life. And I felt bad, and I had, like, messaged her and said, you know, I you know, because it was just sad all around just to see that. Well, I mean, I'm black. I mean, but yeah, it was just sad because, you know, and then they got this girl fired from her job. Yeah. They got this girl fired from her job. They left negative reviews. They were being ableist. They were being rude. They were attacking the girl. And, yeah, it was just all, like, all around. And I was watching the live because she sometimes goes live and does a quick, like, live of, like, talking about tea or what was missed, like, drama or tea on TikTok that she just does a quick run through. And actually, TikTok, let me tell you something about TikTok and the N-word. They don't allow black people to say it either. For some reason, black people get flagged for saying the N-word, so. Yep. I literally made the video. There was the video, the Doja Cat song, I'm Not Your, you know, I'm Not Your Mommy, Find a New Hobby. And I literally had made that video like everyone else, and I said it, like, I didn't say it, but, like, I'm, you know, in the song because I'm black, and I was, and TikTok was like, nope, we're gonna strike you. We're gonna strike you. And I'm like, I'm black, TikTok, but you let white people say it. I've seen white people hop up in a live stream and say it with the hard R towards someone and not get banned at all. And they said it towards a black person on live and they didn't even get banned at all. Like, that's crazy. They are selective. There's a difference between white passing, white presenting, which I don't look closer to white, but it still shouldn't be an issue because I'm black. But again, a lot of darker shouldn't be an issue because I'm black, but again, a lot of darker so anyways, what I was going to say is that I actually saw there is a couple on this app named Trino and Adam, and I don't know if you guys know who they are. They are like cholos, but they're dating, right? They're two cholos that are dating, and we lost the thing, my data. My service went out. Sorry, it went out for a moment. Like, the bars went away and then came back. It does that sometimes. But anyways, Trino and Adam had did a song where they mouthed the N-word, and clearly they're not black. I didn't notice that, right? I had liked the video. I didn't really pay attention to the N-word part where they mouthed it because I wasn't paying attention at the time. Someone had made a video saying, you said what? And I went back and I was like, oh, no, 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 no. Like, I liked the video and I was like, I didn't even know they said it. Like, I didn't pay attention. And their video is probably still up. And they're not black. And I've seen people literally hop in live streams to get people banned. White people will hop in lives and say it with the hard R. Like, yeah. They literally hop in live streams and say it and then try to get the live banned and leave. They literally have gotten to the point where they spam lives. So they'll go into a live, they'll rate it, and in the comment section, like they have done it on my live, they'll comment the N-word in hopes that it gets banned. So, yeah, they, thank you for the gift points. They do that to literally, like, get people's lives banned. I was in a live where a white person went up and said the N-word with the hard R. And, no, he's like, it's probably the, from the stove sound on the TV. Because he was cooking a roast. That's what it was. And it sounded like, you know, but anyways, what was I going to say? Like, there's been several white people that have said the N-word over and over again, and they don't do absolutely nothing. Like, over and over and over and over and over again. Like, someone literally said they were in a live stream where someone that was YT got mad and said the word. And, like, TikTok just doesn't, I don't know, they don't, they're selective on who they censor. I swiped out of the live, but I went to go look at some messages, and yeah. Apparently, Ryan Garcia claims he's being held without his free will. They're trying to give him medicine that he doesn't want. He says they're going to try to keep him for who knows how long. That guy needs serious help. He's been having manic episodes, and he expects them to, like, not treat him like he needs help. Like, come on. My eyes are watering. I just yawned and my eyes are watering. Recently had a fight and won, and it was found out that he was on steroids. He took steroids. He tested positive before the match, and he tested positive after the match for steroids. So yeah, he's been coming on this app. He came on the app and literally legit said that, hold on, you guys. What were we on? Ryan Garcia. Ryan Garcia had went live and made a statement talking about how Hollywood has a child trigger warning, a child ring, like where they do S trafficking. We already knew, like, there's been stuff about that in Hollywood already, and there's been stuff about that already in Hollywood, and apparently he went live and he was talking about it, saying that it wasn't a ring, it was that they eat children. Trigger warning, eat children. So then what happened was, is that he ended up fighting in this fight. He was being really weird, saying really weird stuff. He said that he was acting weird to throw his opponent off, and that he won fair and square, that he was not on steroids, even though he tested positive for steroids beginning of the match, before the match, and after the match he tested positive. He says he didn't take steroids, he doesn't need steroids to help him win. He tried to throw his opponent off by saying weird stuff, whatever, whatever. So anyways, now he's arrested for vandalism in Venice Beach, for vandalism, and now he's saying they're trying to hold him captive and forcibly give him medication he doesn't want. Now, the stuff he's been saying has been really weird. It's been really weird. Well, obviously, I'm going to have stuff better prepared for my podcast, but, like, I don't know. From what he was saying, like, I wouldn't, like, Hollywood is kind of weird, but I don't know, because it's a lot. Like, literally, if you're saying that you say that to, like, literally throw your opponent off, like, who says something like that? But you know. My eyes are watering. Trisha does have a good podcast, but I haven't been listening. Because I know she had Shorty Bear on there once. I'm literally saving to get a mic. One of those blue nano mics, but I don't have the money right now. So once I get paid again, hopefully I get paid if I hit the goal for the cash out thing, for the gift points, I'll get a mic. I need it for the podcast. But yeah, get a background. Well, with a podcast, people are not going to see anything, because it's going to be on like a Spotify where there's like, you know, there isn't really like, because obviously I'm not going to be filming the podcast because it's just going to be me. Oh, I yawned. That's what happens when I yawn. Because I yawned, they water. They give you the gift points, but they got 150k so fast. Yeah, they're just slow at it today. But yeah, hopefully It was like $79.99 on TikTok, the Blue Nano. Like there's one for $79.99 on the TikTok shop, but with tax and everything, it's like $120. I wonder what's. I know Amazon is not gonna be any cheaper. Every time I put this makeup on, my eyes are like red and peeling. And I wasn't gonna even do makeup today because I was like, I need to give my eyes a rest because I don't know if it's a reaction. I don't think it's a reaction. It's like, you know, when you have peeling skin and it's like red. I don't know. I'm allergic to it. Probably some shadows because some of the looks I've done, I haven't had that, like, reaction. Yeah, it's right there.
I said it's trying to bottle them.
It's right there. Thank you for the heart me. Today was storming. She's fine. Today was storming. It was like thunder and lightning. I think it was thunder. I don't know if it was lightning because I heard thunder. So yeah. Thank you. If there's thunder, there's lightning. That's what I like assumed. Look, this lash is not gonna stay on. Uh-oh. I want to take this off. I can't wait to get my new makeup palette so I can use it and probably get some more foundation. I want to try that Il Makiage foundation and see if it matches your skin tone perfectly like it claims it does. I don't know why you ask. How many feet is a 10 feet hole? 10 feet. Duh, that was a... I said, I don't know. How stupid. You said, how many feet is a 10 feet hole? 10 feet. Why did I say I didn't know? Like, Jesus help me, you see? I was just like... But anyways, you said, how many feet is a 10 feet hole? 10 feet. How am I wrong? Or is that supposed to be a trick question? Thank you for the heart, Puff. I should save to get an iPad. Run around, Sue. A carrot is orange. and my lash is falling off. I don't really much like this look. I feel like there's too many different blues. I feel like there's too many different blues going on. And like the shimmer blue is like too light. There was a darker shimmer blue. But no, I'm not gonna stop with the eyeshadow. I just left it because I didn't want to fix it. Because I would have had to start my eye look all over again. Because, I could have used the darker shimmer. I don't know. Feet is how many inches? One foot is how many inches? Isn't that 16 inches in a foot? How am I wrong? One foot is in a foot. I don't know. I just guess. What is this? Math class? I thought this said Evanescence, but... Hold on. Oop, wrong one. No. Sorry, if I could pull up my sound effect. Thank you for subscribing. Hey, hey. I'm probably gonna get off and take this makeup off. I don't think I'm gonna last any longer. I'm tired. I should have never did makeup. Because now I'm getting off early. Why are you telling them to leave? That's kind of rude. I'm getting very sleepy. I broke my cup. That's where it went. I think I could 3D print this part and literally remake a part for this cup. I broke it. And I can see the pieces. Of cup in here. The little like slider thing. Oh, soda acid. Probably, I'm just kidding. I dropped it and I kept dropping it and I broke it. That's what happened. Because I kept dropping it. I dropped it and it broke. Also, this can, literally is messed up. Let me show you. It's in the wrong. Now I got a defective can, look. Like, the design's coming off of it. That's like so defective. Anyways, it's sad because I just got this cup too, but you get what you pay for, right? I could 3D print that piece on and it'll be brand new. It's not like it's completely broken because it's just a little swivel.
proof of OCD. Most people saw results in just 2 weeks. People taking Ingrezza can stay on most mental health meds. Don't remember what described Ingrezza as simple dosing for TV. All the one pill was taken.
Why does it taste like kind of almost cream soda-y? No, but this is Dr. Thunder. This is supposed to taste like a knockoff of Dr. Pepper, and it tastes like more cream soda than Dr. Pepper. No, there isn't soap in the cup. Birth control, no prescription. Should I try old pills? So my friend's daughter got the, is it the IUD one where they insert it and it's, I give her the GGs. It's literally, the ones that you insert, those are painful. I wouldn't do that, but literally people take birth control when they don't want to have a period. That's literally why some women take birth control. That's why I was like, should I try that? Because it, you don't have periods on birth control. If you don't want a period, take birth control. But then I'm like, I don't want to have, because then I'll forget. I'll forget to take the pill. When I have an all vitamin, a multivitamin, which I do need to get multivitamins. I'm going to get multivitamins. Your hair grow. Was that Octavia? No, not Octavia Spencer. What's her name? Olivia Benson. You know, Law and Order. The character's name is Olivia Benson. That's who. But yeah, anyways. I just want to try that Mary Bruce. Thank you for subscribing. I was going to go to bed, but I got to stay a little longer. Thank you for subscribing. But that Mary Bruce really, no, I was getting tired, but I just tried to stay a little longer. Because I've been seeing everyone try Mary Bruce, and they say their hair is growing. And I do need to try to grow my hair. Shrinkage is a thing, but I want to grow my hair longer. And apparently it's supposed to really work, so. And it's a multivitamin, which is great. I need multivitamins. I need vitamin D because I don't get a lot of it. Only when I drink milk, sometimes when I have cereal. Because, what happened was is that, if I don't have any vitamin D, I'm going to get osteoporosis like my mom. And I can't have a lot of dairy because I'm lactose intolerant. I mean, yeah, but, like, intake-wise, because I'm not trying to get osteoporosis like my mom. So, there's that. Oh, thank you for 1K shares, guys. Excuse me. Hold on, guys. Well, okay. Sorry, guys. I've been seeing people and their nice, lovely houses and their nice... I've been seeing people move out of the country. Is that something that I gotta do to have sustainable living? Because I've been seeing people moving out of the country because they can't afford it here. Is that something that I gotta do? I'm just kidding. I don't know if I'll be able to afford to fly out of the country. There's someone that I watch her lives, and she used to live with her mom. And then next thing I know, she's like, I live in Canada. And I'm like, what? Like, no, I won't move out of the country. It's too much of a hassle because you have to become a citizen. And there's a lot that goes into becoming a citizen to get citizenship to live anywhere. I know someone, they went on this trip with TikTok. So TikTok sent some influencers from Musical.ly out to Bali or something like that, Indonesia. And they went out there. They went out there and they never came back. He wanted to live out there. Then it became a lot because he's like, it's a lot to get citizenship. So he just left and came back to America because he was like, his phone got stolen too, his brand new phone, and he didn't have the insurance on it. Some guy rode by on a scooter and just ripped the phone out of his hand. And, like, took off. I'm like, they literally jacked you by scooter? That's crazy. Not the jacked by scooter. But they drove by, they ripped the phone out of his hand, and they robbed him. They took his phone. He was on it. And they just, like, well, he was on it. And so he ended up coming back because he said, it's too much. Thank you for the gift points. It's too much of a hassle to try to get a citizenship. Oh, that's scary. She almost got caught. Anyways, thank you for the gift points. There's another person who he goes live on here, and he moved out of the country, but I think because his family lives there. I think that's why, because his family lives in the in that country, which is why he lives out of the country. Thank you for the GGs. For the gift points. No, you can't. That's why people are moving out of the country, because it's actually cheaper to live out of the country than it is to live in America. Like, that, if you work hard, you can have something. It doesn't make no shred of sense, because there are people that work hard and they don't have nothing. This work hard, and literally Waffle House raised their minimum wage. Did you know that they're going to start paying their workers higher wages? But we know what that means. The food prices at Waffle House are probably going to go up. Like, they're probably going to charge a lot for the meals you get now. And on top of that, whenever, like, a company or places, thank you for the gift points, raise the prices, the taxes always go up. Whenever they raise minimum wage. But the idea of working hard doesn't make sense, because there's people that have a 9-to-5 job and they're literally living out of a car. Are we? Let me open it, but yeah. I've seen a lot of people leave out of the country to live out of the country. But it's hard because you're a citizen in their country, right? Thank you for the gift points. So you literally have to get all the papers in order, because you are not a legal citizen. You can't just move to a country and just start living in it. You have to become a citizen of that country to live there. Thank you for the gift coins. No, you can't, because you're a foreigner in the country. You can't just move there. You have to get citizenship. Becoming a citizen, you can't just move there, because they're gonna say, I know, because one person that I followed, him, when he went out for that event for TikTok, he just ended up staying there. He just ended up living in Indonesia, and he was like, it's too much. No, it was Bali, I think it was. Well, I think that's the same place. Anyways, I'm not good with geography, but he literally was like, it's a lot just to get a citizenship here, to live here, because you can't just live in another country. You have to have the papers to live there. And it's just too much of a hassle. But it's cheaper in some places. Really cheap to live in some places. Cheaper than America. And especially because Canada got free healthcare. Now, are you going to pass up free healthcare? I don't think anyone would in Alaska. Like, not even getting into Alaska is the happiest, well, not the happiest place, but like a really good place for people to live too. Like, I mean, they got better options out of the country than we do, considering that Canada has free healthcare. Asthma. Inhalers went up, and there was a mother who used to pay $10 a month for her child's asthma medication, and it went up. And it say there's a lady that says she goes months without her inhaler because she can't afford it. It's too high. And I think it was either the inhaler that they said, they literally pay, in Canada, they go to Canada to get it because it's cheaper there, and then they bring it back to America. And it's crazy. Oh, are you talking about, Thoreau, or whatever his name is, I think that's his name? But yeah. Well, yeah, but no, I mean, like, well, yeah, Alaska is part of the United States, but there is literally legit, yeah, I know what you're talking about, Justin, I think his name is, but in a lot of places outside of the country, it's real cheap to live. Healthcare is hella crazy here. People can barely pay for their inhaler medications. Inhaler medications are, they're trying to lower the cost. Like, life-saving medications are too expensive for people to afford. Chemotherapy is not cheap. Not cheap. And it's hard for people to even pay for that. And it sucks that people have to pay for life-saving medications a lot of money. Very, very expensive money. And that's crazy. And supposedly, I don't know, there was a man that a long time ago supposedly found the cure to cancer and no longer is living. And someone had, so I was watching this video that popped up on my For You page, and knowing me, I love a good conspiracy theory, okay? There was a guy a long time ago on the app talking about conspiracy theories, talking about insider stuff that he got. Basically, this guy was looking for him. There's a guy on TikTok looking for this conspiracy theorist guy that disappeared. He used to post videos like 2 years ago, he said, and he left the app, and I want to know what happened to him. Look up these videos. He was explaining about them. The guy said there's heads of an organization that, there was a whole bunch of stuff about it. That there was a guy that supposedly found a cure for cancer. He's no longer here. That they're going to, people are going to need vaccines. They're going to withhold vaccines. I can't remember what it was. They're going to make people need stuff, and then they're going to spread it out 10 years, and then they're going to keep spreading it out, and they will have this cure to get rid of whatever it is, but they won't get rid of it. They'll just prolong it with vaccines until finally the people will start realizing, like, hey, you keep putting out vaccine after vaccine after vaccine, and you're making us pay, or not pay for the vaccine, but you're making us take this vaccine, and you keep prolonging it, and people are going to get smarter and realize they had a cure all along to a certain type of disease, that they're going to keep prolonging, and making people take vaccine, like 10, 20, 30 years, and then it was like a whole conspiracy thing. And it was really interesting hearing him talk about, like, the guy that posted the videos on TikTok. He went in and he was looking for him. And I'm like, I need to find this guy too, because I want to go back and see those videos. I need to see the videos, because I want to know. That sounds interesting. And I do think that the government has cures to a lot of things, but they just don't. They don't want people to know. I believe they have a cure to cancer. They just don't want, or someone has found the cure to cancer, and they just don't want the truth out there. There's a lot of things, right? Celebrities, including, I believe it was Marilyn Monroe. Like, before aliens were ever proved to exist, there were celebrities back in old Hollywood that were legit shown aliens. The government literally showed them aliens. Before aliens were even, like, proven that there was proven life forms on other planets, they were, like, who was it? It was, that's why they believe Marilyn Monroe was unalive, because she was knew too much type of thing. She was also, you know, she had a secret affair with John F. Kennedy, supposedly. That's why. too. But they claim, I think she was the one they said they showed her aliens, and there was another celebrity back in the day. They showed him aliens. He claimed he saw the aliens before aliens were even a thought. Because I used to watch that show. I don't know if you guys remember, with the wrestler Jesse Ventura. Mayor, wrestler. And he used to have a show called Conspiracy Theories with Jesse Ventura. One of them was 9/11. The other one was FEMA camps. How Walmart and places like that have underground tunnels. Trailers that are on the back of trucks, all those are like FEMA camps or something. I don't know. I just was like, I used to watch that show a lot with my family. It was Conspiracy Theories with Jesse Ventura. And basically, there's been so many conspiracy theories about 9/11, obviously. But yeah. I don't know. I mean, like, the government knows too much. And literally, like, now that it's finally proven and confirmed about aliens, what we all knew all along. Like, we knew that all along. I literally yawned again and now my eyes are watering. Why are you asking me? Didn't go. That's why I didn't go, because he didn't go for that. He literally went, thank you for the harm, because he was doing some work. And then his phone overheated and he had to park and he saw that was going on. He wasn't going to that. Like, duh, he was just parked. Anyways, what was I going to say? There's a lot. Like, I don't know. I saw that because I keep getting, not like recommended because I don't watch him anymore, but I keep getting Shane Dawson keeps doing conspiracy theories and I'm like, and I saw a video that was like TikTok conspiracy theories. Literally, I did kind of like a conspiracy theory type thing on my TikTok, which got me blocked by large TikTokers at the time. So the actual name of the group on Musical.ly at the time that ran a lot of large influencers' accounts. It was a whole thing. I couldn't remember the conspiracy theory. I literally made the video on my YouTube because I was just talking about it, like what people heard and it being alleged. The TikToker was named Chris, and I forget his girlfriend's name. She had pink hair, he had blue hair. You probably remember them. They used to, I don't know if you guys know who Candy Can is. Like, he's like a guy that wears all pink, him and his girlfriend, and they do like the, they always have like the stacks of iPhones and they have like the fake money, even though it's probably not fake. They live in a mansion, whatever. Yeah. So anyways, what happened was is that I wonder what this movie is. Hold on. The Bad Orphan. That kind of makes me think of that one girl that couple adopted. They thought it was a little girl, and come to find out it was someone that had that, I don't know if it's wrong to say dwarfism, but literally they found out it was a woman. It was not even a child. And that's how small the woman was, because they thought it was a child they were adopting from another country. Come to find out it wasn't a child, because the child started getting really, trigger warning, violent, threatening to unalive them, and they went to give her back to the orphanage, and they had adopted a full grown woman, and they found out, and the place didn't want to take her back,
And they were like, so, because they couldn't have a kid. That's why they adopted. And they adopted out of the country, and then they found out that that was not an actual kid. Uh-oh. That's where he first sees her. He's finding out she didn't die. She's alive. Anyways, we got off topic. I was talking about this conspiracy theory stuff. And now I forgot what it was. Because I saw the bad orphan, and that made me think of the what they thought was a little girl they adopted, but it was a full-grown woman. And they felt bad because they dabbled with the fact of having to take her back because they were like, she's so attached to us. Like, they didn't want to take her back, but, you know, they ended up taking her back. They didn't really want to, but then they started finding out that she was a woman. But anyways, I was trying to think of, oh, this conspiracy theory. I said Shane Dawson, I posted some, but then there was, oh, the TikTok one. So, Sharla, I think that was her name, Chris and Sharla. One has pink, his girlfriend had pink hair and he had blue hair. I had made that video, I went to their page, I was blocked. I was like, you blocked me for saying allegedly? That doesn't help your case, because then it proves it's kind of true, because if it wasn't true, you wouldn't have blocked me. Literally, I got blocked by them, and I was like, me? Me? Like, that's crazy. I don't know who they're talking about. They're probably talking about that one person they adopted. No, that girl that they adopted was not a child. It was a full-grown woman. They found out because they lied on the papers. Natalia Grace? No, I don't think that's who I'm not talking about Natalia Grace. There was another one. No, she wasn't framed. There was one that they adopted a child, and it wasn't. It was a woman that I think had disabilities. And they ended up getting an apartment for her to live on her own. But they found out they didn't adopt a child. They adopted a woman. Look it up, because I saw the whole story. It was on TV. They showed it again. It's literally on YouTube. Why are you making these accounts when you know that you could legit comment? The chats are open. Like, there was no point for that account. The chat's literally open. No, because a child can't get an apartment. How did she get an apartment? You can't put a child on the lease. Hello? They got her a, she got a place. How did she get a place if she was a child? Does that make absolutely no sense? Like, you can't put a child on a lease. This chat went crazy. That literally was a grown adult. Anyways, I will Google it. They knew something was off, because they knew something was off because she did not have normal anatomy for a child. Mind you, that was another thing. When they were giving the child a bath, who they thought was a child, didn't have normal anatomy for a child. So let's start there. Trigger warning. But yes, when they were giving her a bath, they said it was weird for a child to, you know, whatever. When they gave the child a bath,
That's how they also, that was also another flag that they didn't really raise the flag of, like, the person being an adult. They didn't see that flag. They ignored it because they just thought, oh, like, you know, maybe because she's from, what was it, Russia or something like that, they just pushed it off. But then they started realizing something was weird and off. And I do believe that she was disabled, but the orphanage was literally, literally was adopting a grown woman and didn't be truthfully honest when they went to go take the person, when they went to go take the lady back. She said, "Why are you giving me away?" saying mommy and daddy, they thought was really weird. Then they come to find out it wasn't even a kid, it was a grown adult. And they didn't know what to do because they were so confused. They were like, you know, they didn't want to, you know, give her up, but they couldn't handle her anymore. She ended up getting an apartment somewhere. They got her a place, which is crazy. You can't get a child an apartment on their own. And, yeah, it wasn't even a kid. It was a full-grown woman. And there was a lot of red flags and a lot of stuff that they didn't see at first, that they just bypassed it. And then, yes, the orphanage lied to them. They were like, we were trying to adopt a kid and this is what they did to us because we can't have a kid. They couldn't have one and the orphanage lied to them. Like, lied. Like, how are you gonna give a couple, a grown adult, that they think is a kid and then lie to this couple that can't even have a kid? Like, that's horrible. Oh, yeah, actually, I think they... No, because there's one that I'm thinking of that had kids. I don't remember. They might have had kids. But there's one where they adopted a little girl, which this is a whole thing on YouTube. They adopted this girl, and she started being very trigger warning violent towards her brother and started doing things. And he would say, she's, like, doing things to me. They wouldn't believe it. There was like a movie based off of the real story, and eventually they tried to get her to seek therapy because she was getting physical with her brother, very physical with her. I think they might have had a daughter or a son. I can't remember the story, but I do know it wasn't a child. They found out it was a grown woman. They themselves found out. They adopted a... That's what I remembered, because I went to look it up. And yes, she was a grown woman, and they told her to lie about her age. Now I remember what it was. Uh-oh. That's a crazy, wild name. That is insane. TikTok should IP ban these people. But will they? No. That's crazy. But anyways, I do remember because they told her to lie about her age. And she did. And what's that? No. Natalia was not a child. Natalia lied about her age. And literally, she confirmed that she was told to lie about her age. They literally wasn't mad. It was the fact that, I don't remember what else. Hold on. I got, that makeup on my shirt.
Hold on.
Sorry, oh, I gotta turn the light off. I have makeup on my shirt, I got it off. But if you guys see it's like a wet stain, it's because I scraped it. That's why. That's what I remember was the lying about the age. I'm gonna get off soon. Because it's almost 2. That's really weird. Do you have any proof of that? Because no, you don't. So why do you make false accusations? No, I get off at 2. Oh, my hangnail. I know she has a medical condition. Oh. That's crazy. Obviously, she's gonna call 911, dummy. My finger hurt. Why is it in the movies they always survive just slightly and then they die again? Like, what the heck? No, because they started saying I liked kids because they tried to say the person was a kid to say that I like talking about kids. That's why. And I hate when people push that narrative. Like, don't do that. Like, I'm so annoyed. Like,
why even mention that? Because that's weird. But yeah, it's okay for people to go around and falsely call people predators. Like, that's why. Those comments bothered me. I'm not a predator and I'm sick of it. Like, again, you do have to admit that whole situation is pretty weird. Especially, why do people go out of the country and adopt? I understand they can't have kids, but the whole situation is just weird to even begin with. But that wasn't even because people were right. It was because people were making predator comments. And I had to block that because I get, frankly, annoyed. It's like whenever the Discord does something, right? Like, whenever Reddit admitted that there was children in the Discord, and Discord said they didn't care, people don't say anything to them. Like, they don't say anything about that. Like, thank you for the gift points. And literally admitted that they didn't care there was children in their Discord. Like, but yeah, you don't want to clock that. But I'm not saying you, but the people that were making predator comments. You'd be the same people that be on Leslie's live stream and not say anything to her. And literally defended her. Someone said Leslie looked better than me. Well, what kind of a comment is that? Are you kidding me? Leslie doesn't look good, no way. Not even with a minor. That's disgusting. Like, you seem to forget they defended her. That's why I brought it up, because of that. The bad orphan. Because she said, who are you really? You're not eight. That's why I brought up this story, because I just saw that. But it's crazy. Like, y'all be the same people that be in Leslie's live stream, be supporting her and sending her gift points to drink her life away. Or her sitting there with a sign that says, I won't talk till I get this. Like, you should be getting up and taking care of your grandmother is what you should do. You claim that you're there because your grandmother can't walk, but yet you're not taking care of her. No, it was because people were making predator comments, and I get so annoyed because these are the same people that be supporting predators. Like, if I was a predator, I would be registered. I'm not registered. Like, it's so annoying. Anytime there is something that, like, the topic wasn't even inappropriate. The topic was about the couple that adopted a grown woman. Whether or not it was a kid or not. Like, why do people gotta make things weird? And they'd be like, calling me a predator. That's why I went in sub-only mode, because I'm tired of people literally saying whatever they want. Like, did we not learn from the Inquisitor situation? Why is every influencer you don't like a predator? And I'm not saying you, but the haters. Anytime people don't like someone, they always resort to calling them a predator. Not every single person's a predator. So why do we always resort to, whenever you don't like someone, you call them a predator? Like, I've gotten the weirdest DMs. One person DM'd me as their childhood photo and said, since you like children of them when they were a child. And I was like, that was really weird and highly inappropriate of you to, like, DM me. I know not everyone's like that, but it's just so annoying, because then once one person says it, they all say it, and they were doing it all night too, making the stupid username saying PD3O. It's just like, you literally legit have no proof but a screenshotted photo, which someone who works literally in graphic design said it was fake. Like, why do you keep pushing that fake photo? Because someone had a vendetta for me because I said they were allegedly a groomer.
that person left me on scene and didn't respond because they know what they did. Like, I literally have proof that backs up that I'm not one, especially the supposed search history, which, let me remind you of something. What they're trying to say that was is not a search history. Anyone with an Apple phone knows exactly what that is. That's frequented websites. Frequented websites are not search history. And for them to overlay a photo and say that's how they got it from the live stream is crazy. You can't open two tabs at once when you're screen sharing on TikTok, especially when it's mobile gaming. Sorry, my eyes are watery. That's why I'm trying to like dry so my lashes don't come off. But it's real funny to me how you try to tell me what I know because I screen shared. I literally screen shared and I got a warning because TikTok said I can only do gaming. At the time I was making BTS memes and I was like showing people I was making like the BTS memes and asking people's input, and we were for like BTS tickets. And TikTok gave me a warning and said that I have to do mobile gaming or I could be revoked. They said you can't do anything other than gaming. If you're not playing a mobile game, then we will have to revoke your we will take away your access, your mobile gaming access. And I said okay, because at that time it was that really popular baking game. You know what baking game I'm talking about that everyone was playing? That's what I went to play on my mobile gaming when I streamed. I forgot what it was, where you flip the bacon. You guys remember that game? What was it called? You flip the bacon or whatever. And so I went and I started playing that because I couldn't. I said, well, I can't show you guys making the BTS memes anymore because I got a warning. Literally, and here's the thing that I don't understand. If corn was ever showed on a live stream, how come it didn't get taken down? And the person who shared the information before on Karen's live literally said, well, she called me an alleged groomer before proceeding to show the proof and information, which I literally was so mad because it's like, how are you going to throw that out there? And then, you know, and the other thing was, which I'm going to get into that, is the fact that Aunt Karen didn't even agree that I was a predator and why people are still pushing that is crazy. Then the Discord had the nerve to get mad, turn around, and then proceed to call Aunt Karen a predator because she wouldn't call me one, so she's one. Because of the comment that she said about Asian people aging like fine wine and how... Something about Asian people age like fine wine. They didn't like her comment that she said about that, and they literally turned around and called her a predator in the Discord, which I had screenshots of on my Android, but somebody stole that, which I'm gonna have to get a new Android. We're not mentioning that person in this live. Don't mention the name because we are not mentioning that person anymore, but I'm going to work on getting a new Android so I could back up all the photos. But in the Discord, they called her a predator because she wouldn't call me one. They said, why was Aunt Karen was defending her until we sent her that message and then she switched up. Like, we got her on our side or whatever because they tried to play messy because I had shared a message from someone in the Discord saying something, and someone told me to show that message to her, so that's what I did. And then they wanted to be messy and try to make it seem like I was talking shit about her in DMs, which that was not the case. Then turned around and literally called her a predator for no reason. Like, why do these people do that? And they literally have said some stuff about it. They're not going to go away. Frankly, they're not. But the thing is that it really affects someone's online work, especially because it affects a lot. Like, to be honest with you, it's never going to go away because everyone resort, but that's a huge allegation that is sometimes hard to ignore. And I just got to keep debunking the allegation and move on. There's a line going through this through the supposed screenshot. When you take screenshots, lines don't go through screenshots. Explain that. And it's literally because people were making predator comments and I got annoyed. Like, I'm literally not like a predator. I'm literally not like a predator. Sorry, I can't talk. But I got annoyed because this is the thing that they do when they don't like someone is they push their predator. All the time. But you know what I mean? Like, it's just annoying. It gets tiring to have to talk about it, but I do have to address it because it gets annoying. They make accounts after accounts after accounts. And these be the same people that be hanging around with predators in live streams like Leslie. Or he who shall not be named, the leprechaun. Which they had in their Discord. Why does she talk about me? Why does she keep mentioning me? Well, why do people keep mentioning you? Didn't you have a record, trigger warning, for something that you did to a 13-year-old when you were 16? And your uncle is Richard Ramirez? The serial killer? You have pictures of you in a bathtub with kids on Twitter. You talked about someone's child's trigger warning breast, a minor's breast, and the Discord said, oh, he would love it in our Discord. Of course he would, because there's minors in there. And the thing that I get annoyed is that people get away with doing weird stuff, but when it comes to me, you know, I can't mention his name because when you mention his name, he comes out and he harasses black women and he threatens to dox them. And I don't want to give him any more attention because he's not really on this app as much. I think he's like, his accounts are dead. So let's leave his accounts dead. But the only reason why he couldn't delete the stuff he said on Twitter, he forgot his password. He literally tried to go to Twitter to delete his stuff and forgot his passwords to Twitter. Mm-hmm. That's exactly why the stuff's still up on Twitter. He tried to delete it but couldn't because he forgot his password. And this dude comes to harass black women. He tried to follow me on my page and I instantly blocked him. Block. You're not going to come to my page and start with me. And then he went on someone's live and literally said I was talking about him. Why does she talk about me all the time? Why does she mention me? And the person said to leave me alone at the time when they were cool with me, right? And because you're a weirdo, sir. You harass black people in Cash Apps, black women, and you go in Cash Apps and make threats towards them in Cash Apps. Like, you have a criminal record for, you know, who, mind you, Isabella, who is, I can't remember the username on Choo Crew Discord. Literally is still talking shit about me. She is mad because I had my mom block her on Facebook. And because certain people found out who she was and stopped being friends with her because I exposed her for being in that dude's live stream. Defending him. After he had pictures of him in a bathtub with two kids that aren't even his. And you're still after me because I told my mom to block you? Still after me, still obsessed with me, still like trying to do whatever it is in the Discord. Like, you were literally friends with this dude, lying on some black man's name, and literally, you know why all of this is continuing? Because I'm guilty by association, because they say that I look up to a trigger warning child abuser that didn't abuse his child, and people don't understand how the judicial system is against black men, and they say, oh, well, it couldn't be because he was black, he was falsely charged, it was because he did it, is why he pled guilty, which she's literally explained multiple times, and they're still at it with that stupid bringing it up. Still in the Discord, still bringing it up, especially Isabella, and still attacking me for that, saying I defend him, which he didn't do it. Stop bringing that up. It's getting really old and annoying. That's like, what, 10, 12 years ago, and you're still bringing up his past? Like, move on, Isabella. Because Isabella's always talking ish in the Discord, and is mad because my mom's okay. And is mad because I had my mom block her on Facebook. This girl literally had the nerve to say, tell my mom, I received a message from your father, Juan, like she's some psychic. Are you a psychic medium now? That's really weird. And then had the nerve to ask my mom a question, which I know she did, but she deleted it. Like, did my dad ever sleep with me? Why would you be asking my mom that question on Facebook? Which I don't even think my mom saw or paid attention to, because I know I saw that. And when I brought attention to the comment, all of a sudden it's disappeared. And now she's been taking it out on me for the longest time for the simple fact that I had my mom block her. And because other people unfriended her because they saw exactly who she was. And now she's mad because she was in a live stream with a weirdo, having a whole conversation with him. But yeah, he faked a DV situation with George Foreman's daughter. That's cool? That's the guy you hang around with that runs on this app doxing people, threatening black women, talking about minors, being really creepy, being really weird, and then faking a DV situation on a live stream for a skit and thinking it's funny, and people thought she was really hurt because she had kids, and they really called the police to get her help, and it was all a hoax. It was fake, and they thought it was funny. There's nothing funny about that. Literally, the guy broke down on his live, cried, because he's seen his mom go through that. Literally, over the situation, and was hoping she was okay, come to find out it was all a joke. And yet, you're still mad at me over exposing you for hanging around with that weirdo? And you're taking it out on me because I had my mom block you and you don't have proximity to my mother? Like, it's always weird why the trolls try to get in to have some conversation with my mom, and then when I block them, they get mad and take it out on me because you're trying to get personal information from my mom, which she's not going to give you. And she should have never been talking to you. And that's what pissed me off, is I'm like, oh, you've been talking to this person that was once subscribed to my live, hanging around with a weirdo. And I literally told my mom what that guy did. He has charges. Look him up on Google. Mr. Jeffrey Perez. I can't say his name. I say it like that because we all know he'll come out. That's why they say he who shall not be named, because he comes out of hiding when you mention his name. He literally follows black women and stalks them. He stalked a mother and her minor daughter. He stalked a mother and her minor daughter. And that's who you're friends with, Isabella? And you're mad at me? Like, I'm trying to protect so-called friends and people that shouldn't be involving themselves with people that you involve yourself with, because hanging around with you is going to cause those people to get doxxed. And I care too much about my online friends to allow stuff to happen to them. You could be mad all you want, but they needed to see who you really was so they could stay far away from you and the people you surround yourself with. And my mom had no business talking to you when you hang around a man like that. You literally shouldn't even be in the Discord because you're going to be the reason why a lot of people, including the moderators, get doxxed. You are. You're the one that's putting even those people in the Discord in danger. And I'm not even going to say they deserve it because they doxxed me, because I don't think anyone deserves anything. but you are a very dangerous person and people need to stay away from you, far away from you. How are you being buddy buddies and chopping it up with a man that stalked a minor? Like, and I shouldn't have to keep repeating that. It's really weird. And you're mad at me and you're still taking your anger out on me. Like, stop being obsessed. Leave me alone. Stop mentioning me. Do not mention my name at all. I keep getting ish that you keep name dropping me. Like, it's weird. If I tell my mom to block you and she agrees that you should be blocked because of the man that you hang around with, then I'm going to block you so you don't have proximity to my mother. You're weird. You're not no psychic medium. Like, stop. You did not receive a message from my mother's father. It is really weird. If my mom wanted a psychic reading from you, she would have asked you for one. It's giving creepy. Like, do you practice something that you know nothing about, like voodoo? And you're literally practicing the psychic medium stuff, and you're opening a realm that you don't understand? Because clearly it seems like you're dabbling in something that you don't even know what you're opening the doors to. So maybe keep those evil spirits over there. Because it seems like you are going to plague the Discord with evil spirits. I wouldn't want to hang around with someone who opens up an evil realm. And this is not any joke. You don't know what you're messing with. Seriously, I hate when people do things. They dabble in things they don't understand what they are opening the doors to. Evil. Pure evil. And this is not making fun of voodoo or anything of the sort. This is like stuff that you shouldn't even be dabbling in if you don't know yourself what you are doing. You don't portray yourself to be no psychic, so why are you trying to give psychic readings to people who didn't even ask for one? The people that you consider yourself with, literally just keep that pure evil over there, because that man is pure evil. He likes to portray himself to be this big, bad, tough guy, which he's not. But stalking someone is creepy to me. And you stood behind that. And you were literally talking ish about someone who I literally follow. And literally was lying on that man's name. And I could not have you as a subscriber on my page. And if you want to be petty at me for that, then I don't care. I'm not going to allow someone who puts people in danger that is in their inner circle. You will get blocked. Like, mad at me because I had my mom block her. And this girl is still talking about me, still being obsessed. Trust me. And if I remember her username, I will tell you guys tomorrow, because stay far away from her. She literally hangs around the most horrible people. You do not want to get doxxed. Trust me. Literally. Or stalked. This dude stalks everyone all up and down this app. And there is a Mr. Perez that dresses up like Michael Jackson, which is not him. So don't mistake him for the Michael Jackson impersonator. Let's get that totally correct. He is not the Michael Jackson impersonator, like people tried to say last time. Use your common knowledge and stop falsely accusing people, because I'm not talking about that one. But there is another Mr. Perez. If you search up his record, he has a record in Hawaii. And this dude is not on the app anymore. He's irrelevant, so let's not give him relevancy. But the fact that that Isabella keeps dragging me, my name in the Discord, is crazy. And you all hung around that horrible man. And if you were so for the protection of minors, then why didn't you call him out on his behavior? You had people in your Discord like Nova and Leslie. When Nova was asking y'all for money for Wingstop. Oh, but that's not scamming either. And he was literally, let me tell you something. Nova was taking people's money on cameos and not giving them the correct, not giving them cameos, because his cameos are the exact amount it costs to order Wingstop through DoorDash. He was out here scamming people for cameos and literally not giving people a cameo because he was using the money to eat Wingstop. Oh. Besides him wearing diapers, oh, the one time he said in his Discord that he likes to sit in soiled diapers. Oh. He's saying twinkle, twinkle, little star to a minor. That's not creepy, but you want him in your Discord? That's who you had in your Discord? Like a grown, like a man singing twinkle, twinkle, little star to a minor? On top of the other stuff he's done, showing them him wearing diapers, the sucking on binkies, like that's not weird. Oh, but okay. Like I truly, truly, truly don't get this, and like I have been receiving screenshots. Isabella keeps doing this. Because she got blocked. And because people no longer wanted to associate themselves with being friends with her. Because of the people who she hangs around with. I mean, continue to mention me, but it won't look good for you. Because of the person you literally consider a friend. I was not going to let you drag someone's name that were mutuals on this app and drag them all the way. Like, I was not going to let you do that while being a subscriber. If I catch you spreading lies and misinformation, of course you was going to get blocked from my life. What did you think it was? Do you think I was just going to allow you to lie? Like, I was literally watching you. I sound like a broken record because some people don't really listen. And when I do give people your username, I hope people stay way away from you. Really? That's crazy. And the Discord was the same Discord that had him in their Discord, but was threatening to dox his friend. I don't know what Nova's friend did, but apparently they threatened to dox Nova's friend. And apparently Nova's friend messaged me and literally told me that apparently he's trying to take down the Discord or something and wanted to work with me. He said, Nova wants to team up with you to take down the Discord. And I said, heck no, block, delete. I deleted the comment. I didn't block. I don't remember, but I know I deleted the comment. I'm like, I am not going to team up with Nova. Like, you are the wrong person to ask me. I know I don't like the Discord either. But I'm not teaming up with you. A man who says he loves to sit in soiled diapers on his Discord. No thank you. Who was flinging around a Quintana. Literally trying to be Harry Scary. You know, and try to. You know what I mean? Try to literally like be like, come mess with me. Like if that's going to ward people off. That's not how it works. They're still going to send and do stuff to you because you doxed yourself by sharing a news article clipping and they found out where you lived. And you also was dumb enough to give your credit card info and they bought stuff off of his credit card. They bought something off of his credit card because he accidentally leaked his credit card info. And this is the same dude that has a weird relationship with his uncle because one time on live, someone said they witnessed that he literally got mad because his uncle was mad that he wasn't giving him attention. That sounds like a really weird and personal relationship between you and your uncle. Why do you have a relationship with your uncle where your uncle's mad at you that you're not giving him attention? That sounds like a little more than family problems. That sounds like Sweet Home Alabama to me. That sounds like y'all be doing something you're not supposed to. This dude got so mad that he enticed people. Not enticed, but he literally told people several times to dox me because I literally exposed his uncle for being racist and being homophobic. Oh, he didn't like that. He was in the Discord raging. He said, my uncle is not racist. Because someone did admit his uncle was homophobic in the Discord after I shared his uncle was racist. Because he shared a post that says, why are people offended by this, which was the Confederate flag, and not this, which was a group of black men standing in a circle with their pants sagging? You are a white man talking about... I'm not even gonna... Do you know the history behind the Confederate flag and why it's bad? So why is your uncle protecting the Confederate flag and then talking about black men in that manner and sharing that post, but he's not racist, but it's on his Facebook. He shared it. I was just given that information because someone gave it to me and told me that this is Nova's uncle and he's racist. When I shared that, Nova went off. He was like raging in the Discord. He said, my uncle is not racist. I'm pissed off that she would do that. And I literally posted that on Black History Month. Because I think he did it on Black History Month. Like, you're mad at me because I exposed your racist uncle? Then that means that your whole family likes racism and doesn't speak up about it, because obviously you wouldn't be defending him. You would be calling him out. And then you're mad at me? Yeah, and then you want to work with me to help take down the Discord because they're threatening to dox your friends? Nope, that's not how it works. You deal with it yourself. Don't ask me. Oh, wow. What, do you think me teaming up with you is going to take them down? No, you're going to have to make police reports. If they're threatening to dox you and your friends, I would suggest you get all the screenshots. Ask someone who will be willing to help you, because I don't think there will be anyone. But maybe someone might be willing to help you collect info. Save everything you got on the Discord, and then... send it to the police. That's what I advise. Because me and you teaming up isn't going to do anything. And I would never team up with you, so there's that. Oh, Toonami is on. I forgot, because what's today? Sunday or Saturday? I forgot the new... what do you call it? Aired the WWE stuff, and I forgot. I yawned, and now my eyes are gonna water. Robot Chicken. I haven't seen this in so long. Why did that sound like Chris Griffin?
Birthdays, allergies? Superman has been Earth's greatest champion. Just ask him. But if he turned evil, it'd mean Earth's total annihilation. That's why I wrote this. A batarang fashioned from his one weakness. Kryptonite. I pray never to have to use it. Anyway, that look. What's talking to today? What about the other hero? The key to stopping the path of men alive is threat.
Well, I'm out.
Yeah, all these people are just weird. Dang, hang nail. I couldn't get it, I finally got it.
Son of Jor-El and Mara?
I'm Tranzar. I'm a private investigator. I've been looking for you all over the universe for many, many years.
What? No, Krypton was destroyed.
I'm really sorry to tell you this. Krypton is fine. You see, your parents were in the middle of a nasty divorce. Your mom's lawyer, a woman by the name of Mar-El, she's a hell of a divorce lawyer, and so your dad kept threatening to put you in a rocket. Blast you off into space if your mom didn't back off. I mean, every once in a while you read about one of those testing battles where a parent kills their own kid as a way of hurting the other parent, but obviously something that's really rare.
I hate hanging out.
No one could find Jor-El, and your mom's attorney and Jor-El's attorney, a guy named Bron-El. She asked Bron-El where the hell Jor-El was. See, everyone had agreed to meet on a time. Jor-El had insisted. 11 o'clock in the morning. So anyway, they're all standing in the driveway of the house. Everyone's wondering, where is Jor-El? Then they hear someone shout, hey, you dumb bitch. Sorry for the bird damage, man. That's what he said. And they all look up.
They give her the gift. Coins. I'm going to get off because I'm sleepy. It's like 2:36. I'm going to go get some sleep. But have a good day or night where you guys are. I will see you guys later. Let me open up the chat. I'm gonna go get some sleep. I need to get this blue makeup off. I feel like this is gonna be the hardest to get off. But have a good day or night where you guys are. And I will see you guys later. Thank you for liking. Thank you for commenting. Thank you for subscribing. Ooh, we got a lot of subscribers tonight. And thank you for gifting. Bye, guys. Good night. Good night. Good night.